more question which I gave
last
you.
Last question we did was.
No, the question I included
64
after the
by
class. No, after the class I included the homework question and then I sent it on group. This was the homework question. You didn't check that?
Oh, it was on the same note.
Yeah, I mentioned that, no?
No.
Okay, try this now. Just a second. I'm just checking that can we copy this or not. Hello, Sean. Good morning. Have you tried the homework question?
Yeah, sir. Like, I didn't do the whole thing, so I did something else. Like, I did one.
You didn't get the answer. What are you saying? You tried that, but you didn't get the answer, right?
I didn't. Yeah.
Okay. Please call Dev. He has not joined. Sean, can you call Dev?
Yeah, one second.
I know you try with G simple first, okay, and let me know the setup.
Oh, cool, it's gone.
X square plus G square 4, so that so next.
It's coming in like 5 minutes.
So you write the whole.
Without a battery.
Okay, you write the whole triple integral setup and then let me know. Okay, Sean, can you share your setup for G simple?
Yes, sir. I can't find my sheet on that.
Okay. Okay. Hi there, good morning. Have you done the homework question? Dev? Dev, have you done the homework question?
I don't know, I didn't have it down this question.
I mentioned it on group that the sheet has a homework question at the end. When I sent the PDF file, I mentioned that.
Oh.
After the lecture, I included this. I forgot to give you in the class, so I included that after the class.
Oh,
nevertheless, you can try this right now. This is the question, okay? And you first recognize which simple, like we'll solve. See, there are two tasks for setting up the triple integral. What are those? first is R3 simple. Like we recognize which simple like we should go for, whether it is Z simple, Y simple, or X simple, right? And then after that, we find out the reason on the respective plane. If we are going for Z simple first, then our reason will be on like R2. So R2 reason will be on XY plane. If we are going for Y simple, our reason would be on XZ plane. If we are going for X simple, our reason would be on YZ plane. Okay.
YZ.
Yeah. So these are two tasks to set up the triple integral. Now I would like to hear from you guys what is the setup. I have already given you the hint, you go for Z simple.
Yeah, that's because Z is zero, right?
Yeah, because the lower limit is zero. So it is always like good to put zero in the limit so that the term can be simplified easily. So Z is equal to zero, and the second reason for that is we have two functions. See, we are looking for two surface, right? We are looking for two surface that define the boundness of the object. So if suppose we are going for Z simple, so we are looking for Z is equal to f of x comma y, right? We are looking for two function which is in terms of Z is equal to f of x comma y, isn't it? So Z is equal to zero is your lower function, and what is the other one? Just look for the function which involves Z. Is there any other function apart from Z is equal to zero?
So square root of 4 minus x squared.
Yes, perfect. So we have x square plus Z square is equal to 4. So this will give you Z is equal to the square root of 4 minus x square. Okay. Now set up the integral, draw the region. This is we are solving for R3. I'm giving you only 2 minutes for this. Done. Anybody found the answer? Okay, let me explain now. See, we got this. Z is equal to root 4 minus x square. And the first one was z is equal to 0. Okay. Now, this R3 simple will tell us about the bigger function and the smaller function, right? So, we have to find out the lower limit and the upper limit function here. That will act as the function will act as a lower limit and the upper limit. So, like by looking at these functions, z is equal to 0 and z is equal to root 4 minus x square, what do you feel? Like which one is the lower limit and which one is the upper limit here for the first integral? What do you feel? Should we go from 0 to root 4 minus x square or root 4 minus x square to 0?
From 0 to square root of 4 minus x square.
Okay. So, if suppose you are not much confident about this, no problem. Okay. So, we'll draw the reason for R2 here. Okay. We'll draw this reason R. So, how do we draw that? Where this reason would be in which plane? If we are going z simple first, then where that R would be?
X plane. In
xy plane, right? So we will draw x and y axis here. This is y, this is x. Okay, awesome. Because of this, I got so x and y. Okay, fine. So we'll go through all these the condition, okay, which involve x and y, right? So, okay, is this relevant? This z is equal to 0 is relevant here. What is z is equal to 0?
XY plane itself.
Yeah, it is itself a XY plane. So, we are on XY plane right now. Okay. Now, this x greater than or equal to 0? Yes. So, we are in the positive side of x, right? X greater than or equal to 0. Then, what is y is equal to 0?
X axis.
Then x is equal to 2y.
It's a line through origin.
Y is equal to half x.
Yeah, so x is equal to 2y. We used to solve this by taking y is equal to half x, right? So we'll draw y is equal to half x here. This is 1, 2. Okay. So x 2 1, so y is equal to half x is this line, isn't it? This is that y is equal to half x. Okay, what next? Is x square plus z square is equal to 4 relevant in this?
No.
Why?
No.
Why?
Because it's z simple. We've eliminated that.
But this has x also, no? This has x also. So we are looking for each condition which has x or y. Okay. So if x square is plus z square is equal to 4, this is one of the condition which has x. So it definitely relevant here because if we are on xy plane, what is the z value? If we are on xy plane, what is z value? Z value is 0, right? So the condition is x square plus z square is equal to 4. We are on xy plane. So on xy plane, z is equal to 0, isn't it?
Z is 0.
So it gives you x square is equal to 4. It means x is equal to plus minus 2, right? We have already given one condition that will eliminate one of this possibility. What is that?
x is greater than equal to 0.
Yes, since x is greater than or equal to 0, so this will eliminate one of the possibility and will give us x is equal to 2. So what is x is equal to 2?
It's a straight line.
Straight line passing
parallel to y x.
Yes, perfect. Vertical line passing through x is equal to 2. So this is your line. Okay. So the region bound by this is basically your triangle that you can see here on the screen, right? So this is your region, isn't it? Okay. Now how would you, okay, you were confused here that which one is the lower limit and which one is the upper limit, okay? Which one is the bigger function, which one is the smaller function, right? So as I already given you one hint, once you draw R, okay, once you draw R, you just pick any point from this region and plug that in the given function. So if so, which value you would like to put here? Which value is easy to put? You can put any value. You can put any value. So if you put, let's say, origin 0 0, then also this satisfied, isn't it? Because if you put 0 0, so 0, this will be same, and root 4 minus x square will be root 4, which is 2, right? So that is the bigger function. Root 4 minus x square is the bigger function and 0 is the smaller function here, right? So this gives you the idea about verifying this z simple, the limit of the z. Are you getting that?
Yeah.
Mano, is it clear to you? You can pick any point from the region. Okay. Like, you let me know if you're not, you don't want to put 0 0, let me know any other point. You can put any point in the given function to know whether it is bigger or the smaller function. So you can pick any point from this region, okay? From this region, 0 0 is one of the point. This is also one of the point. This is also one of the point, all the boundary points, as well as the all values inside that. So this is 1 1 comma 0, isn't it? 1 comma 0. This is also one of the point. So if you plug that also in the given condition here, like x is equal to 1, so 4 minus 1 is root 3, so still root 3 is greater than 0, isn't it? So that verifies this condition, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so now let's complete the setup of triple integral here. Okay, in which direction you would like to go in this region first? X direction or y direction?
Why?
Why?
Because I don't know, the x is like simple, no? 0 to 2, but the other one is in terms of a function. The y is in terms of a function, right? Half x.
And the lower limit is y is equal to 0.
0.
Right?
Yeah.
So y is equal to 0. If you go along x direction, understand this properly. If you go along x direction, okay, what would be your lower limit and the upper limit of the of x? See, when you go in x direction, so this is the first function you had inside, had once you enter the region, right? This is the first function. What is that? Y is equal to half x. So you're going to convert that as x is equal to 2y, isn't it? You will convert that in x is equal to 2y. So that is your first function. The second function is x is equal to 2, right? What is the upper limit of for x? That is x is equal to 2. Are you getting that? This one is your upper limit.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So there are two values. One is x is equal to 2y. and the other is x is equal to 2. That is also okay because we are not switching the function. If we are going inside the region, we are not switching the function. It covers whole region. Okay? Mm. That is also okay. But if you go along y direction first, your lower limit is y is equal to 0. Mm. So that's, you know, makes our job easy, isn't it? Because yeah. Once you put y is equal to 0.
I meant that.
Yeah, yeah.
I meant y is equal to 0 is the thing and half x in the top.
Yes, yes. So
that's what I meant.
Yeah, perfect. So y less than half x and greater than equal to 0. And what about x?
From 0 to 2.
Yeah.
0 to 2. Perfect. How do you see if you understood this? Okay. So we'll set up the integral here. So this is going to be z is equal to, the next is y is equal to, and this is x is equal to. What was z is equal to? Z is equal to 0, 0 to root 4 minus x square. And y is equal to 0 to half x, and x is equal to 0 to 2. What we are doing here, this is mass density function, right? This is mass density function. So what this triple integral will give us?
The total mass.
Total mass. Perfect. The total mass of the object. Okay. So we just eliminate this. We just remove this by z because that is the function given to us. So this is one of the setup. Okay. This is one of the setup. Now, if you try for the alternative method here, which is like as per the given condition, can we go for y simple first? Since x is equal to 2y, you can write y is equal to x by 2, right? And y is equal to 0. So we are looking for a function which is in terms of y is equal to f of x comma z. Isn't it? For y simple, we are looking for
then you like
surface.
Your R region will be the xz plane.
So that makes sense because if you have a circular region on xz plane, so what is the advantage of having circular region?
The polar form.
We can definitely use the polar coordinates for that, isn't it? So let's try that also. So we'll go for y simple. That is the alternative solution for this. There are two tasks. First is R3. The second is the region R. Okay. So go for y simple first. And so what is the, you know, this? What is the lower limit and the upper limit for y? That's 0 to
half x.
Half x.
Yes. That's 0 to half x. Okay. Now our region will be on xz plane. On xz plane. So will all the condition which involve x and z are relevant in this. Okay, never skip anything. All the condition which involve x and z are relevant. Okay, so x square plus z square is equal to 4. That is one of the condition. X square plus z square is equal to 4. Okay, first let me know how do I, you know, which axis should I take as x and which axis should I take as z here? Either way we can do. Yeah, either way we can do. But like we have been taking x on the as a horizontal line. So we do that only. Okay. So this is xz plane, and x square plus z square is equal to 4 is your circle with radius
2
and center at 0, 0. So 2, 2, 2, 2. Okay. Okay, we'll draw that later. Sorry. What's the other condition which involve x and z? The second is x is equal to 2y. See, x is equal to 2y is the second condition. Okay. So what is x is equal to 2y? We are on xz plane. So on xz plane.
So x is 0.
Y is 0.
Yeah, so then x will be 0, no?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, like that. So x is equal to 0 is your z axis. Okay. And we have one more condition, which is x greater than 0 and z is equal to 0.
Yeah.
Right? X greater than 0 and z equal to 0. X greater than equal to 0 and z is equal to 0. Okay. What is z is equal to 0? This one is z is equal to 0. Okay. And x greater than is this. So the region bound by this is this, isn't it?
First
quadrant. Only first quadrant. Because region bound by x is equal to 0, z is equal to 0, and the circular region, that is x square plus z square is equal to 4, right? Now this gives you the region here. Now we can set up the triple integral. Okay, please help me out here for the limit for r and theta.
R is 0 to 2 and theta is 0 to pi by 2.
Yeah.
Awesome. So 0 to 2 and theta is 0 to pi by 2. Okay. Now once, how do we set up the integral here? This integral will give you the mass. So m is equal to, the first is y is equal to 0 to half x, r is equal to 0 to 2, and theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. Okay, what should I write after this? Like we have dz here first.
Du.
What about after dz? Should I write dy dx or something else? Just dr d theta, because the second integral is with respect to r.
R dr d.
Yeah. R, dr, so r dr d theta. Okay. And what we are finding here, we are finding out the mass of the given object. So we should write the mass density function here, isn't it? So the mass density function is z.
And we have to write x in the y ka thing as half of r cos.
So see, we are going to apply these limits, isn't it, after the integration, right? And the next integration is with respect to r. Are you getting that? The next integration is with respect to r. So our limit has to have r, not x. Right. So what is r, what is x? We have half x here. So what is x here? What is x in polar?
R cos theta.
Yes.
Yeah.
So x is equal to r cos theta. So we can change that like in triple integral. So that would be theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. R is equal to 0 to 2. Y is equal to 0 to half r cos theta. And since it has z here and we are integrating with respect to z, so we'll not change that, okay, because we are integrating with respect to z. Z is one of the variable, the mass density function involves z, so we will not change that. Apart from z we can change everything, but here since we are integrating with respect to z, so we'll not change that. No, sorry, something is wrong here. What is our
dy.
So yeah, we can definitely change this z also. What is z? But you can do that later also if you want. So we are integrating with respect to y. Okay. So what is z, if I ask you here only, what is z in terms of r?
R sine theta.
Very good. Is it clear to Mano and Sean? Z is r sine theta, because our reason r is on xz plane. So this z will act as a y here.
Yeah.
And in polar form, we know that y is equal to r sine theta. So z is equal to r sine theta. So either you can replace here itself or you can do that later. So let's, if you found this already. So r sine theta into r, this r, and dy dr d theta. Please solve this. I give you only 6 minutes.
I think it's half, right? The answer?
No, the answer is one.
So what's cos of pi?
Cos pi is minus one. But where is cos pi?
The final one you get sine 2 theta. Start this thing.
I'm doing on this screen, you can refer.
Even I, so it's half, I think.
Okay, let me check this.
What is cos pi is?
Minus 1.
Is minus 1, yeah.
So, I got minus of minus 1 upon 2.
Yeah, same.
What about you, Sean?
Almost done. Okay.
16 by 8 2. So 2 sin theta cos theta d theta, which is 0 to pi by 2 sin 2 theta d theta. So sin 2 theta is cos 2 theta minus cos 2 theta upon 2.
Oh, cos 0 is not 1.
I got all 3 pi by 2 1.
1. Okay. Yeah, 1 is right. Yeah. So cos pi minus cos 0. So minus half. Cos pi is minus 1.
Plus half. 1. We get half plus half.
So I use substitution to sin theta cos theta.
Why? Not required.
There is I know.
Okay. So the answer is 1. Can you verify the answer of this will be same as the setup which we got earlier? Okay. So the answer of this has to be 1 because we are finding out the mass of the same object. So you can practice this as homework. You can find out, you can complete this integral and verify that you get this as 1 or not. Okay, so that would be your homework. Now next is, okay, write down the next question. That's mass density function. Root x square plus z square, and the region T bound by y is equal to x square plus z square, let's say y1, and y2 is equal to 8 minus x square minus z square. Okay, so we have to do two tasks while simplifying that, or while finding out the setting for the triple integral. Those tasks are R3 and the region. Okay, so R3 simple means, which simple would like to go for here?
Y simple.
Why?
It is straightforward, right? It'll be easy.
Yes. Because we are giving two functions, which is pi is equal to. Yeah, I understand the next.
Then we use x square plus z square 0, and then we get x square plus z square is 8.
Okay, so see, first of all, we are going for y simple here. Okay, because already we are given two surfaces, two functions, which is in terms of y is equal to f of x, comma z. So, which one is the lower and which one is the bigger function here? Which one is the smaller and the bigger? That is the question. Okay. So,
x square plus z square is small.
Yeah.
And 8 minus x square minus z square is bigger.
Yeah. So, if you are able to find out this directly, it's well and good. If you are not able to do that, draw R. Okay. So, this the region R, like R2, will be in which plane? That will be in XZ plane.
XZ.
Okay. XZ plane. And how do we find out that region here? How do we find out the region? How do we find out the region? See, we are going along y direction is a first. Dot. Okay.
On the xz plane, y1 is a dot and y2 is a circle with radius 2 root 2.
So, what is the method to find out the region first? Let me know that. That region is our level curve. Are you getting that? We are going in y direction first.
Yeah.
And there are two surface which says y1 is equal to something, y2 is equal to something. Are you getting that? My y direction is along this. Right? We have two function, y1 is equal to something, y2 is equal to something. How do we find out the region which is going to be plotted on xz plane? Right? How do we find out that region? See, these two surface is going to be intersect somewhere. Right? These two surface is going to be intersect somewhere. So by that intersection is basically your level curve. Are you getting that? That intersection is basically your level curve, and that level curve is going to be projected on xz plane, isn't it? So that is our region, and that is the whole idea behind that. So we are going to find out the intersection of these two surface. That will give us the region, and that will be projected on xz plane. Right, so we'll find out the intersection here. Okay, so intersection will means we equate where the y values are equal. So we'll equate y. So that would be x square plus z square is equal to 8 minus x square minus z square. Are you getting this? See, our region is the intersection. Our region is the level curve. Always remember. Otherwise, if you like, Mano was saying y is equal to 0. So, x square plus z square is equal to 0. This is one circle, which is nothing but the point. Then, if we set y2 is equal to 0, so that is the circle. So, you are getting basically two circle. Okay? But that is not the reason. Understand the difference. That is not the reason we are looking for. The reason is basically your level curve. And that level curve can be found out by solving them simultaneously. Okay, that will be the intersection of these two surfaces, right?
Yeah.
So this implies 2x square plus 2z square.
So we get x square plus z square is equal to 4.
Yes. Okay, so this is your reason, right? And this will be projected on xz plane. So now let's draw the region here. So our region is on xz plane with radius 2, center at origin. Okay. So this is the full circle is our region here. There is no condition at all. So so like in polar form, x square plus z square is equal to r square. R square is equal to 4, r is equal to 2.
Yeah.
So what is the limit for r? Like what is the range of r in fact?
Two.
Lower limit and the upper limit.
0 to 2.
0.
0 to 2.
0 to 2. Okay. And what about theta here?
0 to
2
pi.
0 to 2 pi. Okay. So let's set up the integral. Which quantity we are going to find out here? We are given mass density function. So are we finding volume or mass or something else?
Mass.
So mass is equal to this triple integral, and we are going y simple. So y is x square plus. Okay, now as we know that we are going to integrate with respect to r second, isn't it? Right, we are going to integrate with respect to r for the second integral that has limit r is equal to 0 to r is equal to 2. So the first integral must have limit that has to be in r, isn't it? But here our limit is in terms of x square and z square. So can we convert that in r?
Yeah.
So x square plus z square is how much?
R square.
Yeah. And 8 minus r square. Right? So we can write that here for the lower and upper limit. So y is equal to r square to y is equal to 8 minus r square. What is mass density? Okay, let me just write down this. The sequence of the integration is y first and then r dr d theta. Okay, so always write r behind dy. Okay, so r dr d theta. And what is the mass density function? That is root x square plus z square, and we are integrating with respect to y. So what can we do here? We are integrating with respect to y, and the mass density function is
make that
yes, we can directly r. convert this in terms of r here itself, because it does not have y. Okay, if it has y, we'll integrate with respect to y first, and then later we can change that into r. So this is going to be just r. Let me color this. So r. Now just complete this quickly. Did you understand the setup here? So I won't explain you the integration part now onwards. You will have to just do it by own, either in class or maybe after the class. I'll simply write it down and you can refer back. Dev, are you solving this?
Yeah, sir. Meaning I start solving. I thought we're not doing it.
No, you have to do that. I'm not going to explain this. Very good. So, Sean, did you get this answer? Dev, you started late.
No, once. Can you go up?
Yeah.
Okay. No. I made a mistake. Okay, pardon.
Okay, so see, double integration gives you volume in 3D scenario, right? And area in 3D and area in 2D, isn't it? Right? Similarly, for the triple integration, the like area will be given. If you set up like we set up one, the function is set to one to figure out the area by using double integration. Similarly, to find out area by using triple integration, we have to set the function to one, isn't it? And we do this dv. So this gives you the area or volume. This will give you the volume, right? This was in double integration and this is in triple integration. If you set up the function is equal to one, that will give you the volume, right? We know that, like we know one of the formula, the volume is length into width into height, isn't it? Right? If you set this h is equal to 1, what it will give you? It will just give you the area, right? So based on this information we already knew in double integration, we can set the function to 1 to find out the volume of the given object. Okay, fine. So just write down the question on this. Find the volume of T. Okay, if we have the condition of boundary condition of the region and we set the function to one, that will definitely give us the volume. So that is defined by x is equal to 4 minus y square, x plus c is equal to 4, x is equal to 0, c is equal to 0. Okay, so this will give us the volume. If we just integrate, if we apply triple integration on the on region T, okay, by setting up the function as 1, that will give us the volume, right? Okay, so just set up the integration here. And let me know the setup. Okay, so to set up this integration, there are two tasks. First is R3 simple. The second is region R2. Okay, so for R3 simple, we require two function. Like in which direction you would like to go first here for R3 simple? Will you go for x direction or z direction? There are two options available by looking at the boundary condition. There are two options, either x direction or z direction, means z simple or x simple. So which one you would like to select?
Z simple.
Z simple. Yeah. Z simple. Why? Why not x simple?
Because x is in that y ka thing also, so you can make a relationship between them.
Yes, very good, very good. So that makes sense, because see, if we have only two condition which has z is equal to f of x comma y, we'll select that. Okay, here we have three equation which involve x, so there is a this might not be the good choice here, so we'll go for z simple. Okay, so let me know the lower bound and upper bound for z. See, we have
zero minus x.
Yes, we have x plus z is equal to 4, so z is equal to 4 minus x. So the lower bound is 0 and the upper bound is 4 minus x. Okay, now R2. So our region is in which plane?
XY
plane. So we will draw x and y axis here. We'll draw the region here. So we'll use all the equation which involve x and y. Okay, so the first equation is x is equal to 0. Okay, this one, x is equal to 0, x plus z is equal to 4. So like for x plus z is equal to 4, okay, since this involves x, so it is relevant here, right? We have to use this equation, x plus z is equal to 4. So we are on xy plane, so what is z value for that? If we are on xy plane, so what is z value on xy plane?
Yeah,
who answered? I didn't hear any answer.
Manav
answered. Okay, so zero. Yeah, perfect. So we are on xy plane, so z is equal to 0. It means x plus 0 is equal to 4, x is equal to 4. So x is equal to 4 means 1, 2, 3, 4 somewhere. So this is the vertical line which has equation x is equal to 4. Okay. Now we have x is equal to 0. What is x is equal to 0? Y axis. Right, it means our region is between this x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 4. Right, x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 4. Now, is there any other equation which involve x and y? X or y?
Yes.
What is that?
Yeah.
X is equal to 4 minus y squared. So what is this? X is equal to 4 minus y square is circle, right?
No.
So like what is that?
It's a root curve.
What is it? Is there any name?
Parabola.
Yeah.
It's a parabola. This way
left side, the parabola which open ups in left direction. Okay, because x is equal to negative y square. See, if you can always think in this way, x is equal to negative y square means x is in negative direction, x is negative for any value of y, right? So it will open up in left, in negative x direction, and it's shifted by 4 units, right? And it is shifted by 4 units. So the vertex of this parabola will be at 4, isn't it? X is equal to 4, and it will go like this.
Yeah. local not, on the left.
Not visible. Just a second. Just a second. It freezed, I think. Okay, so you can see the parabola here.
Yeah.
Now, we have to find out this intersection because while setting up the integral, this is required. Okay, so how do we find out this intersection? We'll put x is equal to 0, right? Here, we'll put x is equal to 0 and this will give us 0 is equal to 4 minus y square, y square is equal to 4, y is equal to plus minus 2. So minus 2 plus 2. Okay. Now, this is how we have defined the region. Okay. God bless you, Mano. So we have defined the region here. This is our region. Okay. Now the next job is to find out whether we are going y direction first or the x direction first. So in which direction would like to go first here? Dev is qualified to answer this properly. He has answered twice.
Yeah.
For the reason.
I think you should be going in the y direction.
Are you sure?
Like that between
y direction.
You take the minus and the
plus. What do you think, Sean?
The minus of
yeah, that's good. What do you think, Sean? Which direction should we go first?
So I think y because there are no like changes, it's just like straight.
Yeah.
Well, but if you go in the x direction, like down and then.
So along x direction, the function is changed. The function is switches if we go along x direction.
Not exactly switches, but the direction does like.
No, but that line, that curve is denoted by only one function, right? That curve is denoted by only one function. Oh. The parabola is denoted by only one function. So the function is not switching here if we go along x direction. If we go along y direction, still the function is not switching. But the lower limit.
So you do either.
I didn't ask Mano. Mano, can you explain?
You can do any.
Which direction we should go first, either x or y?
Z direction.
Z. X direction. Okay. Sean is making joke of Mano. Huh? That's bad habit. Okay. X direction. Why? What is the reason? Dev, can you like change your? I'm offering you to. You can change your answer. But with explanation.
Why can't you do? Like I even know the bounds. So you take the negative. The lower bound would be negative square root of 4 minus x,
and then the
above one will be positive 4 minus x, and then the x will be from 0 to 4.
See, so if you go along y direction first, so basically your function is the lower function is this one, and the higher function is this, right? So that can be found by this solving parabola for y. So y is equal to y is equal to 4 minus x, and then y is equal to plus minus root 4 minus x. isn't it?
Yeah.
So, like,
yeah,
we are going to put this limit.
So there are two functions.
Yeah, there are two functions which define this parabola. One is positive, yeah, one is negative.
Whole number for x. If we go in x direction, it's whole.
Yeah, 0 to 4. That's fine. That's fine. But understand my explanation here. See, if we are using, if we are going along y direction first, we are going to plug these values. One is positive root, the other is negative root. So I always prefer to put 0 as a lower limit. So if you are going along x direction, if you are going along x direction, there also we are not switching the function, isn't it? There also we are not switching the function because the whole parabola is defined by only one function. But the advantage of going x direction first is your lower limit is x is equal to 0. And what is the upper limit here?
Oh, it won't make a difference. Either way would not make a difference.
Answer would be same. X but see, what I have said in the beginning, we should go the easier method. So if you are going along x direction first, your limit for x would be 0 to, now we are going along this curve, right? So that is x is equal to 4 minus y square. So the upper limit is 4 minus y square. And what about y? What is the range of y here? That is between two values.
Minus 2 to 2.
Head as you've understood this completely. Okay.
Yeah.
So now we'll set up the integral that will find volume for us, right? We are finding volume. If we just set up the integration, the triple integration, and we just keep function as one, okay, it will give us the volume. So triple integration, we the z simple. So z simple is 0 to 4 minus x. 0 to 4 minus x. Then y simple. No, the y direction, which is y is equal to 0 to, no, sorry, x, no? So, x is equal to 0 to 4 minus y square, and y is equal to minus 2 to 2, 1. Now, this is going to be z dz dx dy, isn't it? Dz dx and dy. Just complete this. Let me know the answer. In the previous question, Sean was correct. Mano and Dev did silly mistakes. Take care while solving integration. You can always verify your steps from screen.
So is the answer 25.6?
128/5?
I got 25.6.
25. See, the answer is 128/5. So 2 5s. Yeah. 2 5s.
Yeah.
25.6. 8.
Yeah.
Minus 1/2 y^4 dy. 8y minus 1/10 y^5 minus 2 to 2. -16
Oh, yeah,
yeah.
I've reached
it there. Okay. Then minus 16 minus plus 32 by 10. 16 plus 16, 32 minus 64/10. 320 minus 64/10. Okay. So this is volume 25.6. Did you get this answer, Sean, Mano? Any doubt?
Yeah, I mean, I did it in the third.
Okay. What about you, Mano?
Yeah.
Should I scroll up or you got these steps?
No.
Fine?
Same steps, yeah.
Okay, very good.
Yeah.
So next question, this is done, no? Okay. So the next concept is about center of mass for the given 3D object. Okay. So I'm giving you the formula here. So like for center of mass, for lamina, do you remember that? We found the center of mass for lamina, right? And the double integration helped us to find out the center of mass, right? Now in this case, since this lamina has thickness, okay? The lamina was super thin. When we were discussing about center of mass of lamina as an application of double integration, but now this lamina has thickness, okay? So we are finding out the center of mass of the lamina having thickness, or we can say that the object, 3D object, okay? So the mass is same as if we triple integrate the mass density function. Okay, if suppose we write 1 here, what it will give us? If I write 1, so it will give us volume. We just found that. Okay, if we write the mass density function. So it will find mass of the given object, isn't it? If the function is mass density function, then the quantity which we find from triple integration is basically your mass of the object, right? So the next is first moment of mass. So for first moment of mass here, we go about yz plane, xz plane, yz plane, xz plane, and xy plane. Okay. So the first moment of mass is my.